It is absolutely safe to log in on apps and third-party websites using your Facebook or Google account. Big tech companies use a standard called OAuth that allows third-party websites to access and retrieve select pieces of information from these big websites in order to authenticate users. OAuth is a protocol that helps big websites grant access to its many users' information to third-party websites or applications without sharing the users' passwords and other private, sensitive details. Suppose you want to make some quick edits to an image online. You go to a website, say Canva, which helps you edit your image directly in your web browser window. However, in order to use its services, Canva requires you to sign up. Since the image only requires a few minutes of quick editing, you might not feel like spending even more time signing up for an account. In our modern, fast-paced world, where the attention span of an internet user is less than a minute, asking a one-time user to sign up and create an account is asking a lot. The user might just leave such a demanding website and find another that doesn't require them to sign up for anything. Most third-party websites that require you to have an account understand the reluctance of users to create new accounts. To ensure they don't lose out on such reluctant users, these third-party websites implement the OAuth standard in their system. An OAuth-enabled third-party website typically gives you two options. Either sign up the conventional way by filling out an online form, or sign up using Facebook or Google. Canva, like virtually all websites on the internet, know that Facebook and Google have mammoth user bases and bets on the fact that you have an account on one or both of those websites. Instead of asking a new user to fill out a sign-up form manually, Canva simply asks you to sign up by using your Facebook or Google account. Suppose you need to use Canva. First, you click on the Sign Up with Facebook button. This redirects you to Facebook.com and checks whether you're already logged in. If you're not, it prompts you to enter your username and password to access your account. Once logged in, it shows you a small dialog box that describes the kind and extent of information that you'll be sharing with the third-party website. If you're okay with sharing the required info with that third-party site, you press the Continue button. Now, Facebook redirects you to the concerned third-party website with an authentication code, which is basically Facebook's way of telling the website that, yes, this person holds a valid account with me. The website now shows Facebook the unique code it acquired when it first registered itself with Facebook as a legitimate website or application. Facebook uses that code to verify the identity of the website, then grants an access token to the website. The website uses this token to gain restricted or limited access to some of your account information, usually your name, email address, gender, and so on. In a nutshell, OAuth lets you give third-party websites a special key that opens only one door of your house and simultaneously protects the master key, which can open all the doors of the house.